In the ISIS beheading videos, the militant known as Jihadi John has a deep, menacing voice.
Obama, you have started your aerial bombardment in Sham, which keeps on striking our people. So it's only right we continue to strike the necks of your people.
But is this the same man?
And then he's asking me, what do you think of the Jews? Just like Brother Omar told him, look, their religion, what? Everyone's got his right to his own belief.
An audio recording of the man we now believe is 26-year-old Mohammed Emwazi was just released by CAGE, an activist group for suspected radicals, which claims it worked with Emwazi. CNN cannot independently verify the audio excerpts. The Guardian newspaper believes Emwazi is this man. CAGE says it recorded Emwazi in 2009, talking about his claim to have been questioned by a member of MI5, Britain's domestic intelligence service. The man believed to be Emwazi says he was asked about the deadly July 7th, 2005 terror attack in London, where more than 50 people died.
He goes, what do you think of the 7-7? I said, man, well, innocent people have died, man. What do you think? I think this is extremism. He said, okay, what do you think of the war in Afghanistan? I said, what do I think? You know, we see the news, innocent people are getting killed. And he started telling me, what do you think of 9-11? I told him, this is a wrong thing. What happened was wrong.
Do you think he really believed those attacks were wrong, or was he saying what he needed to say in an interrogation?
When you're in an interrogation situation and you're a radical, you'd be the stupidest radical alive to cop to having extremist views with a law enforcement official. So he just wanted to get out of that situation as fast as he can.
Emwazi claims his interrogator thought he was trying to go to Somalia to train with a terror group.
And he just started, you know, going on, trying to put words into my mouth, saying, no, you're doing this, and we're going to keep a close eye on you, Mohammed. We already have been. We're going to keep a close eye on you, threatening me.
CAGE says it was those interrogations that sent Emwazi on the path to jihad.
I think CAGE is trying to make a point of, and attack the British government when it's really up to Mr. Emwazi, who made his decisions to go to Syria.